warn ya. So it's gonna be forever. They'll tell you I'm insane. And I got a blank space, baby.
What is a crab in it?
Oh my god.
I'm not fine at all.
Okay, we're good.
We're good, people.
Since it's November, we can now say Christmas is next month. This is a huge deal. So in my head anyway, it's totally justified to start doing holiday videos. I'm just so excited for the holidays. So basically, I made things. I'm really proud of them. And also, okay, huge announcement before we hop into this video. I'm giving away an iPhone 6. There's only two rules. All you have to do is number one, be subscribed to my channel. And just comment on this video what color case you'd have if you got the iPhone. If I pick the winner and you're not subscribed to my channel, sad times because I can't choose you as the winner. I'm gonna pick the winner completely randomly in 8 weeks. So if you want to win an iPhone 6, make sure to subscribe to my channel and comment below. But anyway, we should hop right into this video. 3, 2, 1.
So the first DIY I'm gonna show you is probably the easiest, and all it is putting tape on drawers. But before you just go and do it, I have a few tips for you. So I think it looks really cool if you kind of get like a metallic tape. You can get them at like Target or Walmart or anything like that. And you put it in kind of like a V shape, especially if you have two drawers. That way you can either make like a diamond shape or you can have them kind of like point towards each other like I did. Next little craft I'm gonna show you is a snowflake canvas. First of all, the way I got the quote canvas, unquote, is actually just a little lid off a gift box. They're so much cheaper and they work way better in my opinion. You can either get snowflake gems or you can do it the fun way and go back to like your 8-year-old self and literally make a snowflake. I chose to make one out of this like sparkly gift bag because gift bags are everywhere right now and they're on sale for the holidays. So I got a really cool sparkly one and I cut it into a square and then I just folded it up and the magic happened. You guys all remember making snowflakes, right? Because it's kind of like really, really fun. And I just hot glued that onto my little box top, which seriously, doesn't it just look like a little pink canvas? But I made one of each so I can like hang them next to each other. And then the next thing I did is a glitter clock. So I kind of wanted it to look like a candy cane, but I used pink glitter, so you can tell me below if you think it looks like it or not. But all you do is tape off little sections in stripes on a white clock. If you have like a plain colored clock, I guess that works too. But yeah, so all I did was just put little tapes all around the edges so it's kind of striped with tape. I let the glitter dry for like a day because I kept doing like more glue and then more glitter coats and it ended up looking really, really cool. And I can just like hang it on my wall and it's pretty festive, but it's also good if it's not the holidays because it's pink, so it's not like definitely a candy cane. Okay, so this is definitely my favorite DIY. So I thought if I put iron-on transfers on shirts, why not just like put them on pillows too? And I designed like a couple little teacup things and festive-y things that I wanted to like put on pillows and I just did it. I was kind of scared because like I bought pillows from Target and I was like, I messed these up, I'm gonna be so mad at myself. But it worked out super well and just printed out on like an iron-on transfer piece of paper and then iron it onto the pillow. But yeah, I also did another pillow that said sweater weather on it, and I thought that was really cute. So I have one with some flowery tea and one with sweater weather, and I'm just really happy with how they turned out. So I didn't actually use an iron. I used a curling wand because I didn't have an iron, and it worked really well. Just make sure to like clean the curling wand afterwards. Okay, and the last DIY probably uses the most materials, but it's still really simple. I thought of all these ideas myself, so if they're a little different than you might expect, just flow with it. So basically, I got those same gift boxes that I used for the canvas, and I took the lids off and then punched two holes in the side. Then, okay, the perfect thing that works for wire in the middle to hang the leaves is actually just a handle of a gift bag. So seriously guys, I'm just like DIYing out of materials I had in my house, and I just stuck them through those two like little holes right there and taped them down. And then, okay, I had some really cool felt leaves from Target, but you can totally use real leaves if you want, if the vibe is right and if you're like a really daring person. And I just hot glued them on there, and then I just stacked them up and hot glued them together so that it kind of made like a stoplight thing. And I wanted to be like symbolic about like the seasons changing and all of that, but then I realized that I don't really know if it's even in the right color order, so it's just leaves as a stoplight. So that's kind of cool, right?
So, I really want to know which one is your favorite, so let me know on Twitter, at Megs DeAngelis. Tell me your favorite and I'll try and reply and follow you and all of that. Oh, and also, I'm actually having a few pieces of my secret clothing line in a temporary 6-week store in LA. So, I wanted to tell you guys that I'll be there December 7th. I'll write what time and everything below and the address. If you want to come shop, you're gonna shop with me. Okay, I love you guys. I feel like I talked a lot in that video, but it was all very important, so iPhone 6 giveaway. I already told you the rules, playlist, I'ma be there, pop-up store, December 7th. Okay, bye. My happy little